I believe that our prayer sessions, our devotional services in the morning, are epic events of themselves, put on by many, many heart friends around the world. Mondays, we broadcast from Mount Shasta, from Dwin and Ron Dabrowski's home. Tuesday, we broadcast from Boise, Idaho, at the home of Anthony and Sasha Rogers. Wednesdays, we broadcast from here, or once a month from spring to fall at the Healing Light Retreat. Thursdays, we broadcast from Mount Shasta, from Kathleen and Robert's home. Friday, often it's either from Dallas, Texas, the Sulphur Springs area, or occasionally from Boise or from Canada. Saturday is kind of a mix, right? Depends who would like to broadcast. And Sundays, now we're broadcasting here from Livingston from 10 a.m. to noon. And then there are many other broadcasts. Actually, you can go online and see all of our broadcasts from the East Coast in the evenings. There are numerous broadcasts throughout the day, virtually every day of the week now. And heart friends feel called to broadcast, to release light, to share teachings, to engage with the Ascended Masters, and to precipitate in matter these great energies to help our culture, help our world. And wherever the broadcast is held from, it helps to anchor light in that area. So the greatest beneficiaries are those who broadcast, because the light is first anchored where you are, because you're broadcasting. So that's a great thing. Above the place where broadcasts occur, there are tremendous energies of Ascended Master God consciousness focalized and released that then permanently bless that area, because the energies build and are sustained by angels of the sacred fire, ascended hosts, and the amalgamation of that light is like a reservoir of cosmic energy that then builds in the etheric octaves, and it helps to transmute darkness in the astral plane or the lower energy planes of the earth, and it helps to sustain light so that it's a nurturing field of beingness and joy and holiness and God love. And it's a magnetic thing. It's a cosmically solar magnetic action that occurs that continues to draw energy from the sun, from the stars, from the higher worlds into the earth. So when you invoke light and then you seal the light at the end of a service and you ask that the energy be continued and maintained by your Holy Christ Buddha self, the angel of your presence, your divine self, and that, you know, I made this call for years that all the prayers that I would give, I would have sustained by my higher self, my higher bodies, 24 hours a day. So when that occurs, it's a continuous feeding of the earth of divine light and the spreading forth of that light, the radiating forth of that divine vibration to heal people, to help people, to raise them up, to enlighten them, illumine them, bless them, charge them with divine energies. So this is really a very powerful activity that occurs, and it is so stupendous that those who engage in it know the benefits, because they have better vitality, they have better joy in their life, they have the sense of inner peace. After a session is done, it's like you feel that you've cleaned and cleaned and cleaned yourself up, eradicated negativity, and you're living like above the clouds, above the darkness of the earth. And it's a tremendous thing. We all feel that after these sessions. You feel the great benefit. That's why you keep coming back, is because the collective energy that we invoke is just so powerful and magnanimous. So I encourage some of you to, if you feel called and you have 2, 3, and hopefully 5 people or more, to consider broadcasting, because you will establish a sacred flow field that can eventuate in actually coalescing light to co-create an etheric retreat of the Ascended Masters. This is what happens when people come together in prayer and in service and in joy, day after day, week after week, month after month. The Masters build these mini retreats, or at least a focus of light and the etheric octaves. And I've seen them above homes, like in Bergvik, Sweden. The Queen of Light's retreat was built through the action of the prayers of two righteous souls and then some of us coming to their home also. And above Carol Wells' home, I saw it. Above Dennis Fisher's home. And it's actually a retreat of the Universal White Brotherhood. It's the Temple of Clarity. There's a etheric temple of light right within and above that beautiful home in Vista, California. So above Kathleen and Robert's home and that entire area of their property, there is the coalescing of so much light that in addition to the Vastu temple they've built, there is an etheric temple that's being built and coalescing. And hopefully it will eventuate in the establishment of a physical temple on the property that they have secured right next to their home property. And we're working on this. We're doing it because they know, and we all know, that the more light we invoke, the more the angels can sustain and then grow it and expand it. And it's a powerful thing. So I hope that explains a little bit about the dynamics of why we do what we do in these prayer services, how important they are. And when you at home participate, even though you're not with us physically, you also are the beneficiary of the release of light in your home. When you are engaged, you have to engage. It's not just a passive thing. You have to be active, right? And you can visualize, maybe you have a little altar or a room that you've consecrated for your spiritual work. You can visualize the light also coalescing where you are and impacting your environment. And I believe that powerful, dynamic, giant rays of light go forth from the etheric and bless every home where you are participating. I know it's true. I mean, you feel it, I believe. And so you will be charged. Your home will be charged, your altar, where you pray and meditate and engage. And there will be a dynamic where even where you live, even if you're not a group, a formal group, there will be the establishment of a focus of light where you are that will nurture souls in that environment where you live, in your city, town, village, whatever. And it's a powerful thing. This is how we build the Age of Aquarius and the solar civilization that the Master Omran Mikhail Ivanov spoke of, the solar civilization. We build it heart by heart, devotee by devotee, disciple by disciple, adept by adept, ultimately master by master. So when you have a consecrated time, the angels anticipate that and they prepare to be there with you to amplify the light that you are invoking. And some of you see them. Some of you see the masters. Some of you feel them. Some of you know they're there. So when you're called to participate and you consecrate a time to do this, it's a powerful thing because you will be the beneficiary of the coming of angels and these masterful beings. They will bless you. They will charge you. They will help relieve burdens. They will even help you with your physical health and well-being. During these sessions, I know some of you are going through a lot with your physical body right now, a lot of you, people in this room. I know that during these sessions, you lose all sense of the burden on your body because you're so lifted up in the spirit that it doesn't have any play on your consciousness because you're really in heaven during these sessions, right? I know that happens. I know it happens for me. So if you desire to be relieved of certain pains and sufferings, physical, emotional, mental, spiritual, whatever, come again and again, experience the light. It will keep you in the zone, in the divine zone of divine proximal spiritual development. And you're always going to be raised up and feel better and nurtured and inspired. You know, our Meru University motto is to enlighten, inspire, and empower. Enlighten, inspire, and empower. So we enlighten first, we edify through the teaching. We inspire through the action of the pink ray of the Holy Spirit, and then we empower through the will, the blue fire of God's holy will. And it's a perfect balance. Enlighten, inspire, empower. Yet All these sessions that we engage in are the same. We enlighten you through the teaching. We inspire you through the sacred words that flow and through what the masters share. And the empowerment is definitely there through the rich voice of the Spirit, the Logos, the Word of God that's coming down into our dimension through our voices, our throat chakras, and engaging. So we are anchoring logoic light through our voices, through the power of the Word. We're anchoring logoic light. So you are an extension of the Logos when you speak words of power in the I Am name of God. You're an extension of the Logos. It's a powerful thing. And it's much more powerful than just silent prayer, which can be great and helpful and virtuous and beautiful, yes. I pray silently sometimes when I'm in areas where I don't want people to hear me, on planes, on the way home, and elsewhere. Yet, when I can speak out loud and dynamically pray, it's the power of God. It's the Shekinah glory of the I Am that I Am that's just precipitated in matter. And it's like, whew, you know, it's like when Iron Man comes down, right, and lands on the earth, and you see this whoosh, you know, and everything is like, yeah. I mean, that's the power of the Word descending into matter. It really is. And others of these Marvel heroes, you know, they just land and then, phew. I mean, even science fiction is, you know, a lot of it's true in a higher sense. And you can visualize all kinds of crazy, wild, imaginative things in your visualization during the prayers. And guess what? A lot of that actually occurs. You just don't see it. The angels are magnificent beings. They do magical and miraculous things. We just don't always see what they do. So the more you imagine, the more you empower them to do this power creative work, and you collaborate with and cooperate with them, the more awesome it is. The more awesome it is. So I hope that gave a little bit more understanding.